Emily Fisher, Alyssa Pollock, Rachel Greco, and Lindy Foster. Now, therefore, be it resolved that the Board of Commissioners of Forsyth County, Georgia, does hereby recognize and commend Forsyth County 4-H Senior Horse Bowl Team for their outstanding accomplishments. Be it further resolved that a copy of this resolution be recorded in the official minute book of the Forsyth County Commissioners, and that a copy of same be presented to the Forsyth County 4-H Senior Horse Quiz Bowl Team, in testimony whereof we have hereunto affixed the seal of the County of Forsyth, State of Georgia, and signatures of the members of the governing body thereof, given at Cumming, Georgia, this 17th day of May, 2012. Congratulations, ladies.
Moms, come on down. Come on, get your pictures. You can come down.
Those were cameras. Come on down. Come on down for us. Good job, ladies.
This would be when you can come forward if you want. If you want to come forward, take a picture.
Let's go back here.
Okay.
Who's mom?
At this time, we're at public comments. Please read the...
Thank you, Mr. Chairman, and members of the board. We would like to take a moment to review the meeting procedures. Please silence all cell phones and electronic devices. Please refrain from disrupting the meeting through general outbursts, applause, or comments. All comments shall be directed to the entire board and not to a particular commissioner. If you have documents for the commissioners, please provide these to the clerk. If fewer than 7 copies are submitted, only 1 copy will be retained by the clerk as part of the permanent record. Those who wish to speak must sign up by completing a public comment form available just outside this room. Information regarding specific requirements to address the board is listed at the podium. Please state that information prior to speaking. Per the county's broadcast policy, the county is not responsible for statements made during public meetings and does not warrant the accuracy of such statements. The public comments portion of the meeting is intended to allow speakers to make a verbal presentation to the board. The number of speakers is limited to 10. Speakers are selected on a first-come basis and will be heard in the order in which they signed up, with the exception that Forsyth County residents will be heard first, with non-county residents to follow until the allotted time has expired. Each speaker is limited to 3 minutes. The public comments portion is limited to 30 minutes. We have 3 public comment speakers this evening. Our first speaker is Kurt Winterstein.
Good
Mr. Chairman, Mr. Commissioners, I am Kurt Winterstein. I live in Commonwealth Subdivision, and I speak only for myself. Tonight, I would like to discuss some results, and some of the results I want to discuss I found in the newspaper. This is the Atlanta Journal-Constitution. It is May the 4th, 2012. And when I look down at building permits for the first quarter, I see that, again, Forsyth County is a leader. During the first quarter of 2012, according to the newspaper, we issued 341 building permits. Now, last year, we issued 265 permits in the first quarter. According to my math, that's a 29% increase. That is very good considering the economy that we are experiencing. And as I said, we are a leader. Gwinnett was second at 237, Cobb at 192, and DeKalb was at 44. So we're doing very good in this economy. And as I said, we increased by 29%. Now, when we look down at Cherokee County, we see that they went from 48 building permits in the first quarter of 2011 and went to 75 building permits in 2012. Now, that's over 50% increase, but they only have 75 building permits, and we got 341 in the first quarter. And I hope they build a very nice county over in Cherokee County. But this idea that builders are going to flee this county, I don't believe the data supports this. So I am in favor of respecting the UDC. I don't see any reason at all to streamline the UDC. I think we're doing a good job, and we need to continue to do what we've been doing. Now, recently I heard someone talk about that we need to expand our tax base, and I agree with that. They talked about that we need to diversify, we need more businesses in here. But what we really need is we need employers that are going to pay the salaries that are necessary to purchase the homes that we have in this county. So where are we going to find these employers? Well, if you go down on Windward Parkway and you go down on North Point Parkway, you'll see those type of employers. They're in those buildings back. They're beautiful landscaped areas. They build very nice business parks down there. And we have executives down there. We have a supporting staff down there. Those people are earning the type of money it's going to take them to buy houses in our county. I would like to see us have some of those building the business parks in our county. Now, we probably don't have the economy right now to do that, but we need to be proactive. We don't need to react to things in this county. We need to be proactive. We need our planning people, and I do believe we need business overlays so we can have attractive areas. That wasn't put together without the government. Alpharetta helped them put that together, and that's what we need to be doing up here. Thank you, Mr. Commissioner.
Thank you. Our next speaker is Kenneth McMaster.
Mr. Commissioner, members of the board, my name is Kenneth McMaster. I speak for myself and my four other family members that are out in the audience. I speak for no one else other than the subdivision of Sheffield off of Campground Road. I was at your work session, the last work session the other day, and we are the folks that are buying the homes in the Castile subdivision. You had some discussions going on regarding that subdivision and some fines or fees that are due there, the percentage allowed. I wanted you to see the folks that are involved in this. We've been involved in this since February of this year. We're going on our fourth month trying to close on these houses. Just to give you a little bit more background of the subdivision itself, there's 43 lots in there. There's currently four houses in there that are built that have residents in there now. There's three houses that have been there since 2008, unoccupied, not sold, just sitting there because of the economy. Something happened with the receivership that came along. We had an opportunity to put a purchase request into those houses. We went under contract. We had to go through receiver approval, landowner approval, bank approval, and then finally judge for a court approval in order to purchase the homes. On the 27th of April, we were going to close on those three homes. On the 26th of April, we found out that there was an issue with the CO for two out of the three homes. Apparently, one of the three homes has a CO on it. I'm asking the board to consider their motion the other night relative to two things. One being allowing the owner to receive the full 75% of the award for the reduction in the fines, et cetera, really to help us move along, because nothing's going to move until they get that resolved. I ask that of the board to consider it, just like some of the other subdivisions that have been there. Please understand, there's 43 lots in the subdivision, seven houses, three houses unoccupied, 36 lots. They're not built on yet. And I believe that those lots are still are under contract to possibly be sold as well. So that we have an effect that there's three of our families that are trying to move into them. My son, who had to move out of his current house that he was leasing on the 27th, because we thought we were going to close. He doesn't have a house right now, so he's in real dire need to have this happen. If there's a way that you all can look at this and award that opportunity to the owners, and look at it and allow to see if you can, and allow the COs to be issued before the fines are paid, because we're just waiting. It's just not happening, and we're afraid that we're going to lose the whole scenario ourselves. So if you have the opportunity to do that, I'm not sure when you're going to do it, whether it's tonight or next Tuesday or whatever, please take into consideration, we are the families trying to move in there. And right now, we've been waiting for months. So anything you can do would certainly be appreciated. Thank you all.
Thank you.
Our next speaker is Brad Carlton.
Good evening. My name is Brad Carlton. I'm a resident of Growth Park subdivision off of Sanders Road. I've been there since 1994. Growth Park is a neighboring community built in the mid-1990s with 149 family homes. It's located directly across the street from the property that's considered for annexation into the city. I'm chairman of the Growth Park Zoning Committee, and I'm representing Growth Park at this meeting. Over the years, Growth Park has successfully worked with developers along Sanders Road, including the Primrose Daycare Center, the Discovery Point Daycare Center, the Northeast Georgia Heart Center, the Prudential Real Estate Office, and the existing Medicus Property Office Park. While Growth Park encourages growth and development along Sanders Road, we are interested in smart growth that will not have a negative impact on our community, including but not limited to traffic safety, noise and lighting pollution, as well as other changes that may have a negative impact on our quality of life and property values. Just so y'all know, Sanders Road is a winding country two-lane road that connects Highway 20 to Buford Dam Road and Mary Alice Park Road. The speed limit on that road is 30 miles an hour. The entrance of our subdivision is at one of the sharpest curves on the road. And since I've lived there, we've had two instances of cars exceeding the speed limit and not being able to make that curve, and they've ended up in our children's playground. Luckily, no children were hurt. We missed the bullet on those two issues. So I just want to let you know the condition there. We're willing to work with Medicus and Dr. Holbrook on this property. We simply ask that the new development on the subject property mirror the existing medical office buildings and that it's interconnected with the current entrance. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Over comment?
Our next speaker is Jack Gleason.
Good afternoon, commissioners. My apologies, my entire was the plan not coming down this evening, and then I changed my mind and said I would try and make a public comment. So, apologize to the police department about my driving habits. Apologize for showing up late. But what I want to speak to is very important. Twice now, I have sent this board a copy of the 11th District Court of Appeals ruling on Tri-State Water Wars, where it stands today. Twice now, I have sent a copy of the Georgia Department of Natural Resources surface water supply application, both are an exhaustive read, but within the bodies of those, you will find all the information you need to ascertain and that a partnership with the City of Cumming with regard to the water intake infrastructure is the most prudent thing we can do. Literally, for what the Court of Appeals has remanded to the Army Corps of Engineers at this time, we stand today with the unique opportunity of being where the county was 4 years ago, when everything was on the table. Now is the time, if ever there was a time, now is the time for us to align ourselves and Cumming, Forsyth County and Cumming, in such a way that pleases the Army Corps of Engineers and EBD and favors sustainable water supply allocation for us in the future. Now is that time. I've done extensive research on this. The county commissioners at that time felt it most prudent to abstain getting into the water business, and Cumming smartly took advantage of it. They were growing, they were the county seat at the time, they were superior population demographics at that time. The people of the county wished to remain rural. That was a nice try. The pressures of urbanization from the Atlanta urbanized area being what they are, we are what we are today. But we're a great, powerful, strong community. And we will only stay so if we have a sustainable water supply. And better still, if we can get along with our brothers, sisters, neighbors, cousins, family, at the heart of Forsyth County, that is the City of Cumming. Their leadership has been there for 200 years, collectively. They've done a fabulous job. Been to the last couple of their council meetings. Unfortunately, I don't believe they understand what's at stake here. I could just strongly encourage you to review those materials I sent you. Otherwise, I don't know who's talking to you, but for the fact that we're at this stalemate, I believe we've been somewhat ill-advised. I'll leave you to devices. Godspeed. Thank you.
Thank you.
That was our final speaker, Mr. Chairman.
Thank you very much. Adoption of the minutes. Chairman, take a motion to adopt the minutes of the regular meeting public hearings of May 3rd, 2012.
I move.
Second.
We have a motion and a second. If there's no discussion, please vote on the motion. That passes unanimously. Chairman entertains a motion to adopt the minutes of the work session and the executive session of May 8th, 2012.
So moved.
Second. We have a motion and a second. If there's no further discussion, please vote on the motion, which passes unanimously. Chair would entertain a motion to adopt the minutes of the special call meeting of May 9th, 2012.
So moved.
Second.
We have a motion and a second. If there are no further discussion, please vote on the issue. And that passes unanimously. Chair would entertain a motion to adopt the consent agenda.
So moved. Second.
We have a motion and a second. If there's no further discussion, please vote on the motion. Unanimously as well. Which brings us to public hearings, and there are none. Old business, DR order.
Mr. Chairman, members of the board, business number one, EA120020, DR order, Inc., located in Commissioner District Number 1. This is a public hearing regarding a request for variances to the Forsyth County Unified Development Code Table 11.2B to allow lots in the Sabro subdivision to have a side yard setback of 5 feet with 10 feet between foundations, and to Chapter 18-2.4 and 18-4.5 to allow lots in Sabro subdivision to have a minimum lot width of 45 feet at the front building line. The applicant's change in the original site plan show 131 single-family homes. Property is located 5.5 miles south of Cumming at the west end of Dela Lane, approximately 800 feet west of the intersection of Hawker Drive. The proposed conditions are shown on the screen. Thank you.
Thank you. Chair entertains a motion to, this is not a public hearing. Are we just voting on this?
Yes, sir.
Okay, very good.
Yes,
sir. Okay. Mr. Chairman, at this time, I believe
all questions have been answered in this, maybe Ethan and maybe the lady had questions. So I would like to make a motion to approve the variances for D.R. Horton to Forsyth County Unified Development Code as shown on the screen by our staff.
Sir.
We have a motion and a second. If there's no further discussion, please vote on the motion. And that passes unanimously. Item number two, request for sewer reservation agreement.
Mr. Chairman, this is a standard sewer reservation agreement. It had to be removed and put on the table previously. I believe the developer requested that so they could acquire easements. They've gotten everything in place. They are now asking for the board to move on this. Again, it's a standard sewer reservation agreement.
Thank you. Ken, we have to take this off the table first?
I'm already going to take it off the table, Mr. Chairman.
Thank you. That's okay. Chair would entertain the motion regarding this.
I'll make a motion to approve the sewer reservation agreement with M&amp;N Properties LLC for 1,567 gallons per day of sewer capacity at the Fowler Plant.
Second.
We have a motion and a second. If there's no further discussion, please vote on the motion, which passes unanimously. Okay, now we're to the area that Ken added something.
Mr. Chairman, we're just on old business number three on these high votes.
Oh, okay.
And I will go ahead into that, that's okay.
Yeah.
Mr. Chairman, members of the board, old business item number three pertains to basically four votes that have been taken by the board commissioners, as you will see in your packet. One was taken on May 3rd, two others on May 8th, and one additional on May 9th, all pertaining to the City County water contracts, and all of which implicate Board Rule 108.03, which provides that votes on substantive or main motions that are ties basically act as automatic postponements until such time as the tie can be postponed. With respect to the City County water contracts, given Commissioner Amos's recusal for his declaration of such, which is ongoing, these ties will not be broken. And for purposes of the record, we can read through them, but I think there's little utility to that. They are basically just a hodgepodge of various motions that were made either to send over spreadsheets or to not request an extension of the contract. I'm not asking for you to make a motion to defeat them. I would ask that we make a motion that all of them be deemed withdrawn. The only reason for that is simply to have a clean record that these matters were basically intended. That's all I'm asking. I don't think that would put anybody or any side of whatever you may have voted on the motion an advantage or disadvantage, which is why I'm not asking for them to be defeated. I'm simply asking for them to be withdrawn based upon the practical reality that they will never, that tie will never be broken. Mr. Chairman.
Thank you. I just want to make sure there are three, it's the three bullet points that you're saying. What should we?
I've got
four bullet points. Should we take them one at a time, you think? Or?
For purposes of the of this matter, if we had a motion to withdraw all of the motions set forth in old business agenda item number three, I would be perfectly fine.
So moved.
Chairman, I've just laid down. Second.
Thank you. We have a motion and a second to withdraw these four items. If there's no further discussion.
Mr. Chairman, just real quick, who made the motion? Just trying to help out. Thank you. Okay.
If there's no further discussion, please vote on the motion. And that passes 4-0 with Commissioner Amos being
present. Okay. You have no sense of humor.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Okay. New business, I believe.
New business item 1A is on the application 3589 in Jerry and Jerome working in Commission District Number 1. The request is to rezone 1.376 acres from A1 to CBD for an automotive service establishment with a total building area of 4,240 50 square feet and 7 parking spaces. The applicant is also requesting a variance to eliminate 40-foot side yard buffer and to eliminate 50-foot side yard setback along the northwest and west property lines. The property is located on Scott Road, approximately 2,000 feet south of the intersection of Metastro and Gap Road, and a setback from the right-of-way approximately 500 feet. Planning Commission recommends approval of the conditions, recommend approval of the rezoning from A1 to CP with conditions, and those conditions are shown on the screen. Thank you.
Thank you, Tom. Chair, would entertain a motion?
Yes, Mr. Chair. One question, Tom. Are we, with the revision condition two, are we coupled with that the way it's written? Just to approve them as shown with staff.
Conditions fine. I'd be written it for them, and it satisfactory to them, so we're good with it.
Just time I'd like to make a motion that we approve zoning application 3589 Jerry Ingram from A1 to CBD with variances to Unified Development College and with the condition as shown by staff and screen.
Second.
We have a motion and a second. If there's no further discussion, please vote on the motion. And that passes unanimously. New business number two.
Mr. Chairman, with respect to the last agenda item, the clerk just advised me that there was no call out in the motion of the actual variances having been approved as well. If that was the board's intent, I might ask for a motion for reconsideration and do that one.
You talk about it. Jerry Ingram?
Yes, sir.
Okay. I said it with conditions as shown the staff.
Mr. Chairman, members of the board, with respect to this added item, I know that item number three is the calling for a public hearing on June 7th with respect to the May 9th proposal that was submitted to the City of Cumming as a non-binding proposal. But pursuant to this addendum, or this a modification to the agenda, the Board of Commissioners could, if it chose, could consider and make the May 9th proposal a binding proposal as well. Now, I have handed out to you all the bullet point list that went over to the City of Cumming, comprised of basically 4 points with respect to the intake, no lump sum payment for the intake structure, 5-year renewal of existing raw water agreement with 5-year, or excuse me, finished water agreement with 5-year option. And you see the sub bullet points on that. Raw water was a 15-year renewal with a 15-year option, and then there were some additional terms. The Board of Commissioners could, pursuant to our rules, make this a binding proposal, but that will take a unanimous vote of those that can vote.
Thank you. I would make a motion that we approve the May 9th proposal for the raw and finished water contract to the City of Cumming as a binding proposal and deliver it to the city with the following addition. 1, a mutually agreed upon stipulation in the agreement that Forsyth County has no obligation to pay invoice number 2012-010-50719, and the invoice stands withdrawn.
Second.
We have a motion and a second. If there's no further discussion, please vote on the motion. And that passes 4-0, Commissioner Reynolds refused. Okay, now, consideration of the June 7th public hearing.
Mr. Chairman, I make a motion to withdraw that.
Sir.
We have a motion and a second. If there's no further discussion, please vote on the motion. That passes 4-0, with Commissioner Reynolds refused. Item number 3, City County annexation of tax parcel number C40-09.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. That is a matter that we discussed at the last work session, and pursuant to that discussion, it was agreed to add this to this evening's agenda, primarily for the purpose of seeking some input from individuals from the Grove Park subdivision. This is the City of Cumming's request, actually an applicant's request, to us by the City of Cumming for the annexation of C40019 tax parcel, which is displayed on the screen. This is a request. It's a piece of property that is currently zoned A1, which is agricultural, and that would be zoned and the City of Cumming has indicated it would be zoned to a commercial designation. It looks like everything in our packet indicates it would be used for some sort of a light office, office or perhaps a medical building. We have heard feedback this evening, I believe, from an individual that resides in the residential subdivision across the road. I believe I provided you input last time that with respect to the county's future land use map and our existing land use map, that what is being proposed on this parcel is substantively different than what is currently our agricultural zoning. I think I went over with you at the last work session what sort of the options are. If there is in fact an objection by the county, that does bind us over into a dispute resolution protocol that involves DCA. But quite frankly, I think the board was grappling with whether that was warranted in this situation. So I'm bringing this to you this evening. I believe I have fulfilled my directive with the board, which was to make contact with the residential subdivision and invite them here. They've been kind enough to come. And at this point, I just need to get guidance from the board as whether you wish to object to this annexation or whether you wish to deliver a letter of non-objection to the city. Mr. Chairman.
Thank you. One question. I think the previous time we talked, this was time sensitive. Does it remain time sensitive?
Well, it does, but for purposes of us being in a regular meeting, there's no requirement that we articulate time sensitivity, which you actually will be lying.
Excuse me.
I make a motion that we approve the annexation of tax map number C40-019, the City County annexation.
That's fine. What I'll do is that means no objection.
Second. We have a motion and a second. If there's no further discussion, please vote on the motion.
Brian?
Well, I think we just need to, Mr. Chairman, you'll need to articulate that it's 4-0 with Commissioner Tam.
He's supposed to pop back in.
We need to wait for it.
That passes unanimously, Counselor.
Thank you.
Counselor, is there a need for an executive session?
There is not, sir.
Is there any further business come before this board? Chair will entertain a motion to adjourn.
Second.
We have a motion and a second. If there's no further discussion, please vote on the issue. That passes unanimously. We are adjourned at 5:42.
You'd like to say, Jason, I can't wait.